throwing back to that 1 week that was always left before visitation day for all you boarding students. You remember that 1 week? While you are stretch a week, come before visitation, I'm throwing back to that week. Man, to find someone who had grub or money around that time, they were like a god. So, today I remember those Hunger Games because we're still playing those same Hunger Games. Nekatim Bukulu, any employee will tell you, any worker will tell you, that last week before salary comes is hard. It's very hard. My name is Tina Fierce One and welcome to Scoop and Scoop. So there's this hashtag that's been going on Twitter. The hashtag was hashtag surviving Sandra, and I changed my hashtag immediately after I got to find out what exactly was going on. Now, they were trolling a particular girl. Reason for her being trolled is because she did some, well, rather regrettable things in her past. And when I say rather regrettable, they are really regrettable. Like, when you read her story, the first thing that comes into your mind, you're like, ah, Abby, what in the do? I'm also going to hashtag it. But anyway, there's part of it is she slept with someone's father and posted it up and said she slept with that father, with that person's father just for an iPhone. Most people are calling her a liar, a con man. Even Franga Shumba came in. But the thing though about this whole hashtag was, we actually sat by and let someone get trolled into depression. And I'm like, the hell? Who are you to have standards of truth? Who are you to be there and say like, no, morally speaking, she is wrong, she deserves this. Who are you? Let he without sin cast the first stone. And I was looking at all the people on her TL who are using the hashtag, who are trolling her the most. And I'm like, if I wanted to troll any one of these people, it would be like, very quick. They would all fall like dominoes, but I'm choosing not to. And the reason why we choose not to do that is because by the time someone tweets and says, sometimes it's better to just die and leave this world, she is depressed. You trolled her into depression. So wait, how would you feel if tomorrow morning you actually got up to a suicide watch? Like, what the call? I know everybody on the timeline feels like they have to. They have they are the best with the punchlines, with the comebacks. But some of this shit needs to be stopped. You have no right to troll anybody. You have no right to be that judgmental. Everybody is living their own life, to each his own. And half of the girls who are on this TL saying like, nah, she deserves it, she did this, half of you have done worse-ish, but we have just not yet seen it. There's a lot of skeletons in your closet for you to be coming out here and trolling a girl. Like, I understand it was okay for her to be shamed at first, but it moved from shame into trolling, into something just despicable. And it's a trending hashtag. Like, how vile are we? How vile are we humans? Why do we feel like putting someone down actually uplifts us? What's so beautiful about it? Check out the hashtag and you'll tell me what you think. But I'm going to stand by my word and say hashtag I stand with Sandra. I do not like trolls. Trolls are horrible. Trolls are the type of people who lead you into a situation, into depression for life. Trolls will make you do the most annoying things. And what's sad, half of the people that be trolling you, oh my goodness, if you looked at their lives, they are sad. Internet trolls live the most sad life. That's why we call them trolls. Not because they're pretty. Come on. Would have called them princesses and princes. As of yesterday, ladies and gentlemen, CID, yes, he was called in. Reason why he was called in, they wanted to find out. Man, I can't. So we had our people on site, and of course, when he walked into the police post, they couldn't let us get in. But I also wanted to be among those journalists who was going to see those bullets. I must tell you, I'm assassinating. Yeah, but that ambulance. Kwamujukira bebe was wearing a cast for a long time. Atajukira masasi go no guy, gari wano, ne wano. Was there another one like in the shoulder? Magarabi. Anyway, he went to police. They wanted to find that out, and they wanted also follow up on the person who actually did the actual shooting, who was already in custody the night it happened. Uganda. Anyway. Is it? Hey, and on that note, now I don't know if all of you saw that infamous post that went up on social media. It went actually a bit viral. I hear apparently Henry Tigan saying that Bobby Wine is the person that introduced him to weed. He's the person that taught him how to smoke. That's why his career never took flight. Oh no, it took flight then fell because he was just partying and smoking weed and it was all Bobby Wine's fault. I'm like, wait, first of all, Henry Tigan right now, like. Anyway, post went up. A couple of people actually did believe it, and they also went ahead and called him out. They're like, Henry Tigan, what are you even saying? Like, people were mad. So as of yesterday also, reason I am to tell, he went to report a cyber crime. Because according to him, he did not say those words. They were not his words. They were fabricated against him. So he went, put in a cyber complaint to two Facebook bloggers, right? And they're out there looking for them. I was like, okay. Na yenge bebi chali yao. Bebi ya Henry Tigan katibio tuchimanyi mbubi fuu. Kubanga ngenza ku police. What about those other rumors we used to hear from back in the day? Apparently back in the day, Bobby and his recreational situations were always lit. To a point, there's a time I hear Ambu Silver Chagulanyi told Juliano Manji, Boba told us Bobby Navy of the Mokola. I don't think your career will be back. To a point, I actually sat down and thought about it. I'm like, what happened to the entire Firebird crew? Banjo man, Yachita, Nebu Mubuza could be Bobby Wine Agambo. Why? Uliari Bibia? Ndibi yange. Butcher man, twasemba kumulaba nga ali ku police station nga ekimuyombya enkoko ya neighbor mbu ya jitya. Seriously, this is not a lie, by the way. It's no lie. Bamutwala ku police mbu alidde enkoko ya neighbor. I'm wondering how a lame guy could chase a chicken that fast. Ani omulala yabyo? Master Parrot. Where is Master Parrot? Naye yabako. Yavako. Ate bwe ngamba okuvaako sigamba okuva ku scene. Ngamba okuvaako. Master Parrot. Then there was Mickey Waini and the Darista Bobo. They have always going to be failures. We don't understand. Who else was in Firebest? There were many. Then there was Phantom Lovins. He gave us one song, and that was it. That was it. On Palula. We never saw him again. So it begs the question that how come amongst the entire Firebest crew, only Nubian Lee survived? Was he the resilient one? Was it a brotherhood? Was it an understanding that others didn't get? Because, you know, at some point, Bebe Cool was also in Firebase, right? So, there's a common denominator here, and I want to understand why people keep walking away. Why? Why do people walk away? Anyway, we'll get into that. Yeah, hashtag Mugene Mfune Ndagamuntu. And we thought another rap was a very hideous song to deal with. Good Lord, ladies and gentlemen, I hate to be the bearer of, I don't know if it's bad news or good news, but our president of this here nation, yes, that's Mr. Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, has a new album dropping. Oh yeah, we've been in studio, we've been cooking. Yes, it's dropping apparently an album. Now this album only has 5 songs. One of the songs is called Nonstop. Museveni, Nonstop. I was like. Then another song, Kambakala Kate. And Chadja, I'm coming with the titles. Then another song. I look at the other song is what? Kubanga. Twebederemu. Wow. Our president didn't come to play. He has a 5-track album out. Saba Vulubalamu Agenda Kola Echivuluane Kololo. Yes, it's a full album launch. Our president finna come through on the stage. I can't. If there's a president who has mastered the art of showbiz, I think it is my president. Lord. So let's look forward to that. That's been my, 10 minutes of yelling? At TVS1. Is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook you can catch me at TinaFierce1 or Scoop and Scoop. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's at TinaFierce1 with an H. Thank you for the follows, thank you for the likes. And if you have anything that you want to reach out to me on, you can use any one of those platforms. I personally will see to it that you get a response or a reply. I'm out, catch you tomorrow. Peace.